Red Chair Diaries. It's Wednesday, the 3rd of August 2011. I want to bring you a couple of updates. One is I had all my hair cut off again on purpose. Forcing a hairnet on all that hair I had was a bit much. I really do look like my father. And I do have a patch of the psoriasis back there, which I want to show the doctors today when I went into the clinic for the assessment. Anyway, that was one thing. The other thing is, I worked till 9 last night. Well, I was actually getting off work on time. I made a point of trying to get all my tasks done. And it took me, I left at 9. I tried to leave at 9, but they have some kind of finger biometrics thing as a punch clock. And it will not accept my finger. It's not this finger, it's this finger. And I think that I'm washing my hands so much in that fish place, and then using detergents, to clean to the degreasers and the sanitizers and everything, that I've got nothing left on these fingers. And this went on for it went on for 15 minutes, and then I finally had to get the manager on duty, and she couldn't. I was doing it right with my finger and trying to put oil on it from my head and things like this. So she finally had to put her code in. They won't pay me the 20 minutes of their machine not working. but that's the way it is, I guess. Anyway, it was so stormy last night, the power almost went out in the store. We had such a lightning storm. The rain started not long before I went to work. I was working from 4 to 9, so I left here about, 20 after 3 or something. And my goodness gracious, oh my. When I got out of that place, I had parked in the parking lot that you're not supposed to park in. That's okay. The lightning was so fierce. You're scared to walk across this parking lot. And I got in my car, and I was driving home, and I have no recollection that I have ever driven in a lightning storm before. Because I'm going from pretty well the center of town to downtown to the outskirts to one of the suburbs. And it was pitch black. And, the roads, the lines get bled out, from your vision, and everything's so glary and lightning. And I don't like night driving. I've only got the one good eye. I just, it's just extremely nerve-wracking. But I got home without incident, and here I am again, pardon me. The lightning and the thunder, I have never been through anything like this, and we get some harsh thunderstorms here. The dogs were too scared to be noisy for the most part. And we didn't lose power. Ted says power went out twice while I was at work, but not for a long period of time. And we had so much thunder noise, it literally shook the house. And that doesn't happen all that often. The vibrations were that strong. And the lightning was so, omnipresent, something like that. It was just everywhere, that the Halifax airport had to be closed. Equipment got either blown up or destroyed, or fuses blown or something. And the weather was so bad. Hours and hours the airport wasn't open. And this went on. So I got home about 9:45, I guess, and I think I stayed up till about midnight. And this lightning was on almost until I went to bed. It went on for hours. I've never experienced it. It was on before I left work. Very scary. Very scary stuff. Anyway, that's what went on last night. Then today I went in for the psoriasis assessment, and usually they're pretty fast there. I got there 15 minutes early, I was there an hour, and the whole thing was me waiting, except for the pretty well the minute assessment by the doctor. That, you know, he has to come up and check the percentage and all of that that's on my skin, my legs, and my head, and all of this, you know, for that Enbrel study. And I mean, it was annoying, you know, because I'm used to them being faster there, and just me sitting in a room. Like, I didn't take a book with me. And this time I told him I was not changing into a Johnny shirt. I'll drop my drawers. I said, I've got a lunch date. I don't want to be sitting here any longer. So that's what we did when he finally got there. And I just pulled the pants down. He could check the legs and everything. And pulled the shirt up, and he could check the belly and the back. And that was it. You know, it was just ridiculous. And then more rain today. Anyway, we went out for a good lunch, and oh my God, I just had a nap. It's about 7:30 right now. And then the rain started again after we got home today, so it's just been a real lovely fall day here in August. Two beautiful days off, Sunday and Monday, and then I went to work Tuesday. It was a mess, and then today's a mess. But I'm off today. I'm in tomorrow afternoon again. The other thing was this weight loss thing really is happening. You know, I was able to wear my black jeans to work again. I could actually get into them. I could get to this shirt I got 6 years ago, I think it was, in Philadelphia. Can you see that? You know, the Liberty Bell. I don't know if you can see, because my scale doesn't work here at home, so see, it is happening. That's, I know it looks huge here, doesn't it? But that's a profile that I haven't had in a long time, because I was bigger here. So I can replenish my wardrobe, or not replenish, repatriate. Yes, Bobbin, it's okay. So that's really making me feel good. My arthritis is, my hands hurt, my legs hurt, because I'm back and forth in the freezer and the fridge and everything. So it's not like I'm working in Arizona-like conditions, but it's about the best I can do. And sold my first fish head last night. I didn't know they sold such a thing, and it was sitting there on the ice table, and a woman, so she was like something, angel heart. You know, she was an older black woman, and she wanted the fish head, and nobody said there was a price lookup number for fish heads. You see, I was just supposed to sell the salmon, either whole or half. And she said, no, it's 99 cents a pound. And I thought, there's nothing 99 cents a pound in this place, you know. So I called, but I thought, you know, I don't know everything, you know. It's only been 4 or 5 weeks. So I called one of the bigger stores, and the guy said, yeah, there really is a price lookup number for fish heads. So he gave it to me. I keyed it into the, you know, to the scale that's hooked into the pricing. And there it comes up, you know, $2 and something a kilogram, and that means 99 cents a pound. And so she got her fish head, and it cost her a dollar something. I could just picture her doing some kind of voodoo thing with that fish head. Anyway, I like to learn something new, and I had a female customer, young lady, tell me that I was giving her excellent customer service. I didn't know where something was, so I said, I'm going to take you to somebody who does, and I left the booth and took her. And then I had a fellow and his girl last night tell me that I was the nicest one behind the counter there. I was the best one behind the counter. And they seem to like it, the customers, because if I take something at the ice table and have to weigh it and put the price tag on it, you know, the barcode, I walk around the counter and give it to them. I actually put it in their hands and show them the price again and ask if I can get them something else. And some of them are so surprised by this personal touch, you see, but I don't like to reach across this large table with all the ice and the fish and leaning over things, you know? I don't like that. So it's kind of, that's just my customer service way of looking after people, is to try to give them that little extra part that they're not used to in the big stores. So anyway, works for me. So anyway, those were a couple of little updates for you. And this hat, I told Chris Ficcionato that I would show him my Greek fisherman's cap because I like his cap. This was $50 at Picky's Cove last year, the year before. It made in Newfoundland, though. It's not made in Greece. And it's one of the few hats that look any good on me because I don't have the head for a hat. And this is my Harvard hat that I bought when I was there. Not at Harvard, but at the Harvard bookstore. I've never gone to Harvard or anything like that. So a couple of years ago, I like this hat, so I wear this one around. But there's my head, my Rod Steiger head. Anyway, Michael from Red Chair Diaries, you take care and stay out of those thunderstorms, okay? See you around the tube.